Hey friends, what's up? I'm equipment editor Jim Park. This time we're going off-road with Mack's Command Steer steering assist option. We're going to put it to the test with a pair of Mack granite dump trucks at an aggregate quarry near Easton, Pennsylvania. Mack Trucks launched Command Steer for its Anthem highway trucks back in February of 2020, just before the pandemic broke out. The granite line of vocational trucks got Command Steer about a year later. Owing to the timing of the rollouts, Mack hasn't been able to host a ride and drive event to showcase Command Steer until now. Truck riders and other members of the media got their first demonstration in a quarry owned by a longtime Mack customer, the H&K Group, back in September. Before we strap in and start driving, don't forget to subscribe to HDT on YouTube and please give that like button a swat while you're at it. I'd love to know what you think about steering assist systems. I'm not convinced they offer a great payback on long-haul highway trucks, but they'd sure be a welcome addition to any truck operating off-road. Let me know how you feel in the comment section down below. All right, let's do this. Construction trucks might just be the perfect application for Command Steer. Mack's standard power steering already does a fine job with the 20,000-pound steer axles and the big 425 tires, but the difference between standard power steering and Command Steer is a bit like the difference between power steering and Armstrong steering. Command Steer adds an electric motor to the truck's existing steering system. The motor is upstream of the hydraulic steering gear, so the steering gear only sees torque from the steering column input shaft. The steering gear doesn't know there's a motor helping the driver turn that shaft, but the driver certainly does. It applies about 8 foot-pounds of torque to the steering shaft, which means the driver doesn't have to. There's no difference in the steering performance or road feel, but turning the steering wheel is much easier and much less tiring. It works in the opposite direction, too. Command Steer suppresses the input often felt at the steering wheel from uneven terrain or when hitting large rocks or fallen logs. The motor reacts to those irregular forces hitting the wheels by countering with an applied force of its own. That virtually eliminates steering wheel kicks that can sometimes jerk the wheel right out of the driver's hand. And it's pretty smart, too. With guidance from a bunch of sensors, it knows the direction the driver is steering. If something like a rock tries to knock the wheels in some other direction, Command Steer will keep the truck on the driver's intended path. Mack says Command Steer reduces steering effort by 85%. I'm not sure how they came to that conclusion, but I am sure that a driver would be a lot less tired at the end of the day wrestling a conventional power steering configuration around nasty job sites. So now that you know how it works, let's see it in action. Crews laid out a short serpentine course on the floor of the gravel pit about 200 feet down from ground level, and they also dug shallow trenches about 4 to 8 inches deep and offset by several feet in some cases in another section of the quarry. The Journo drivers first ran the course in a granite not equipped with Command Steer for a baseline comparison, then we hopped into another granite with the Command Steer installed. The difference was, well, like night and day. The Slalom course was a series of tight S-turns requiring hand-over-hand steering with the non-Command Steer truck and literally one finger on the wheel with the Command Steer truck.
So this is a granite without the steer assist. Yeah,
that's it.
You can see I'm having to work a little bit on the steering.
That's for sure.
I'm not knocking myself out, but there is some effort involved here. 20,000-pound front axle, limited turning radius, but we're making our way through here.
Okay, so now we're going to try this with the Command Steer. The other granite we drove earlier didn't have that option. This one does. And right away, it's like driving my car. The other one, you had to work a little bit. It was a nice, firm feel to it, but this is certainly one heck of a lot easier, especially when you got a 20,000-pound front end. You know, as you can see here, I'm just basically one-fingering this. Maybe one palm, but here we go. All one finger. I'm going to let this thing straighten itself out coming around here in just a second. So I'll take out a comb and get everybody mad at me. So you couldn't do that with the
other granite. There's no way you'd be able to turn that wheel fast enough to make a maneuver like that. And I did not knock that cone down. I'm going to let her straighten herself out here in just a second. Straighten up my GoPro too. Okay, work my way through here. Make the cut. Hands off. There we go. Straighten yourself right out. Very nice. That is really slick. The fact that it'll do that and bring you out going straight again.
The next challenge was a simple backing maneuver. We had to pull through a tight U-turn and set up to back into a dumping area. It's the kind of thing drivers do dozens of times a day.
So the theory in this one is you feel the effort to spin it around and then, you know, you have to reverse it back to get it back, whereas normally it, you know, back to zero and neutral position when you're reversing. So.
Yeah. Now we're reversing back into a tipping situation here. Fabricated, of course, with cones, but you can see again there's some effort to put the wheel. Okay, so here I am. I dump my load, put it back into D, and boogie on to the next one. Now we're going to try a U-turn here and then a backing maneuver. Go to this U-turn here, I'll let go of the wheel again and let this thing return to center. Again, one palm on the wheel. Not recommended from a safety point of view, but it sure shows you how easy this is. Okay, pulling into the drop zone here. Now, hands off the wheel. She straightens right out. Now let's do that and go for lunch. So now I'm gonna put it in reverse. We've got R1 here. And we're gonna back into the loading zone. Again, this is such an easy maneuver to make with command steer. I mean, it's absolutely no effort at all. Would I say my car feels stiffer? It's not an exaggeration. But of course, when you get up highway speed, it all starts to stiffen up and you've got a nice firm feel to the steering. So beautiful setup, I'm thinking.
The final obstacle was a row of 8-inch deep trenches arranged laterally across the truck's path. They shook the daylights out of the occupants of the cab, but the command steer eliminated any steering kick.
And of course, this truck doesn't have the command steer on it, so without the command steer, it has no return to center position. So if I turn the wheel, I got to work it back to center. It's not going to come back on its own. That adds a little bit more work. Although I will say, even though it doesn't have the command steer, that's a really solid feel for the steering. It's nice. So here we go. Into the ruts. Hands are basically just hovering over the wheel at this point. And the wheel's not even moving. This thing is guiding itself through there like it knew where it was going. With the other one, without the command steer, the wheel was doing a lot of this as the wheels were taking the impact of those ruts. So, wow. So now we're approaching the serious one. I'm gonna put this thing into C2 here in just a second. Okay, so now we've got an even deeper set of ruts. Same idea, we're gonna see this command steer hold the course. All by itself, you can see in that shot there how deep they are, probably 68 inches, and they're oscillating all the way through.
So Jim, we've kind of loosened this up, and if you want to put the diff locks on, but if you want to try to make it through with that, we can too.
Yeah, I'll throw them on now rather than later.
So here, click that once, and then interact.
Hold that up. Yeah, okay. All right, here we go, C2. 17-to-1 reduction, 1400 RPM or so, and look at this steering wheel, not even moving. I don't have to fight this at all. I'm gonna just pull her slightly right and straighten it out. Stay on the track. Yeah. gravity on the wheel at all. This would probably add 2 or 3 years to a driver's life if he didn't have to struggle like this. Wow. That's impressive.
I got a little bonus ride up a really steep grade. I figure it was about 20% at least, to demonstrate the grade gripper feature and the mDrive's startability. Grade gripper applies the brakes and releases them after about 3 seconds to prevent the truck from rolling back on a hill.
Now you're really a little bit further, just go up a bit further, Jim. So press manual, and we'll go down to C2, or C1 on liftoff actually, all the way down. So it'll show you up here, yep. C1. There we go. Now, while we're here, it'll show you the grade gripper. So you've got a 3 second delay before you have to, before it'll roll back or touch the accelerator.
Yep.
So if you just, there we go, now away we go. There you go.
Down this 20-something percent grade, 40,000 payload, 70-some change loaded, and we're creeping down here at C2, so basically idling. I'm not touching the brake pedal, compression braking is holding us back, and I'm in C2 with the 17-to-1 reduction.
C2, is it? Yep, 17.
C2, yeah.
Yep. So once you're straight here, Jim, just stop. Her up.
There we go.
Great. Now, if you just hit reverse. Now, you got to, once again, you'll have a 3 second delay across to the accelerator.
Yep.
And you just feel the grade gripper hold you and you can accelerate up the hill.
Okay. Sorry, you were me.
Okay.
Okay, this time we're on this big steep hill. I'm stopped. Got the grade gripper active. What I'm going to do is take my foot off the brake. It's going to hold me. I'm going to shift my foot over to the accelerator, and then we're going to back up the hill. So I'm in R1, fully loaded, 70-some thousand pounds. I'm going to see what this thing can do. So foot's off the brake, over onto the gas, and backwards we go. Wow, that's pretty impressive.
That's it.
Right. There,
yeah.
I'm alive.
So there you go.
There we go. Okay, now it's got a C2. Yep. Okay, we're coming down here. The engine brake hasn't come on.
Yeah, it's going to, because you're going so slow, yeah, it won't need to.
It's just holding us at 1,000 RPM coming down here.
There you go.
And I owe the mDrive transmission a little respect here, too. Each of the Granites have the mDrive HD 14-speed automated transmission. It has 2 ultra-low creeper gears. C2 has a ratio of 19.38:1, and C1 has a 32.04:1 ratio. Top speed in C2 at 2,000 RPM is just 2 miles per hour. At the other end of the gear range, top gear has an overdrive ratio of 0.78:1 for pretty economical highway driving. Mack also had a couple of Anthem highway trucks on site, doing pretty much the same demonstrations as we just saw with the Granite dump trucks, although on a less severe scale. I just want to reiterate that Command Steer is sensitive to road speed. As speed increases, its influence on the steering gear diminishes. At highway speed, and with the motor doing almost nothing, the steering feels exactly as you'd expect a non-Command Steer truck to feel. It's invisible until it's needed, like in a stiff crosswind, for example. The system will help counter the forces trying to push the truck right or left by applying a small amount of torque in the opposite direction. The driver will feel almost nothing, but a little less tired from countersteering into the wind all day. It'll also respond in the case of a steer tire blowout or if a steer tire slips off the edge of the pavement. The driver will not have to fight to bring the truck back. Command Steer does it all for you. And there was just one casualty that day. The right front steer tire of the gorgeous red Granite suffered a rock cut and slowly but surely deflated as it made its way back to the staging area from the trench test area. Not surprisingly, that kind of thing is a near daily occurrence in places like this. Well, that's about it from Mack's Command Steer demonstration event. You'll find lots more test drive videos here on the channel, and we have a bunch of HTT Talks trucking videos as well. Check them out while you're here. If you enjoyed the video, please give us a like, and if you have any thoughts on assisted steering technology, good or bad, please leave us a comment. From H&K's Easton Quarry in Easton, Pennsylvania, I'm Jim Park. We'll catch you on the next one.